Hi everybody, welcome. If you have followed the intro class of Savitri, you can add this one on. It's a Yin Yang class and I hope you enjoy it. Alright, we're going to start with sitting on our hands and our knees. So your hands are placed under your shoulders, your knees under your hips. And then see if you can bring your awareness to the tailbone. So the tailbone is the final part of your spine, the end where you used to have your tail, and then you start moving your tailbone from left to right. So your hips and your pelvic bowl is going to move from left to right, maybe a little bit from forward to back. And just let it move as you like. So you can move circles forward and backwards, figure eight. You can just move as you want, make it nice and juicy, nice and flowy. And then start moving up to move from the lower back. So you keep moving from the tailbone as well, but start moving also from the lower back. And then start moving also maybe a little bit bigger, a little bit faster or slower, however you want. And then gently start also moving from the place where you start at the torso, between the shoulder blades, from the shoulders. You can move your elbow, you can move from the top of the shoulders, and maybe you can even take your neck with you and take your ears, take the crown of the head and just gently, nicely, juicy move through the whole spine. So really take everything with you. You can go a little bit back, you can go a little bit forward. Just wake up gently the whole spine. Moving up and down also, especially pay some attention to the part between your shoulder blades. And maybe sink every now and then through the elbows, through the wrists. And let's wake everything up. Alright, then you come back into center. And then curl your toes, flex your toes onto the mat. And then start by lifting the sitting bones up. Keep your knees bent. Maybe you can walk your hands slightly forward, really spread the fingers wide. And lift your sitting bones high up into the air. Come into a puppy dog and see if you can look towards your navel, lengthen out of the arms, let the shoulder blades roll away from the spine. And then from here you can lower your right heel towards the floor, bend your left knee, and then change the sides, bend your right knee, straighten out your left leg. Just walk your dog a little bit, opening up the backs of your legs. And then start by walking the feet forward towards your hands. And from here, just let everything dangle. So open the feet to hip distance apart and then let the head drop down, let the arms drop down, let everything hang. And maybe you can start by moving from the tailbone again and just sway your arms around your legs. Just let everything dangle. And then come back into center. Bend your knees, feel your feet strongly onto the mat and start by rolling up vertebra by vertebra. Let the head be the last thing that comes up. Until you stand completely firmly onto your mat. Now feel that you can bring the weight of your body into the front of your feet. Inhale, exhale, bring it to the heels. And again, inhale, bring the weight into the front of the feet, and then exhale to the heels. Then inhale, bring the weight to the outside of the feet, and then exhale, bring the whole feet back into center. Again, inhale, outside of the feet, inhale, back into center. And inhale, lift your toes, and then start by spreading the toes one by one onto the mat. Now start by stepping a little bit wider than your mat. So come like 1 foot distance apart, wider than your mat. And then we're gonna do the golden seat. So see if you can drop your tailbone a little bit, or a variation on the golden seat. Just bend your knees a little bit. Then open your hands to the front of your womb. And then start by closing your eyes and bringing your awareness inside of the body. See if you can reconnect with your breath. Allow the breath to travel along the spine. And when you're ready, gently open your eyes and then inhale, arms are coming up, look up. Bring the arms up. And then
exhale, bring your arms to the sides, bend your knees, and then start bringing your weight to left and right. And on an inhale, bring your hands towards the floor, look down, and then exhale, open the right arm up, twist up. Exhale, coming back down. And then on an inhale, open again, left arm goes up towards the ceiling. Inhale, coming down, and take the energy from the floor into your chest, lifting it up. Exhale, pushing it up towards the ceiling. Feel your hands and your feet connecting. Inhale, reach high up, and then exhale, release down. Inhale, coming back up, reach up, and then exhale, let go. Inhale, coming back up, reach high, 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 and then exhale, let go. Really use your breath. Inhale, exhale. Last time, inhale and exhale. Then stay down, and from here, as if you're taking something heavy up from the floor, as if somebody's pulling you from the front of your hands, come up. Really lift up, inhaling. And then when you're ready, exhale, bring the energy back down into the center. Gently. And really feel your grounding again through your feet. Let's do that one more time. Inhale, arms are coming up. Exhale, bring your arms to the side, bend your knees, open heart. You can move your feet if you want to. And then inhale, bring the hands back down to the mat. And then exhale, open the right arm up towards the sky. Inhale, coming back down. Exhale, left arm comes up. And then coming back down, inhale, taking the energy from the earth into the heart center. Lifting up. Exhale, bring it back up, push it away. Feel your feet and your hands connecting. Inhale, reach high. And then exhale, let go. Inhale, reach up again, and exhale, let go. Inhale, up, and exhale, let go. Inhale, high up, and then exhale, let go. Last one, inhale, up, and exhale, drop down again. And from here, as if somebody's pulling you from your hands again, come up, gently, gently, inhaling, bring it up. And then when you're ready, bring again your energy back to center. And then feel this energy ball just in front of your belly, just below the navel. Feel your feet. Keep breathing deeply. Close your eyes. Take a few breaths. And of course, you can repeat this another 2 or 3 times if you want to. Or you can just go to the next variation of the sun salutation. Just take 2 blocks, you place it next to your feet, you come and stand in between the blocks. And then again, ground your feet, lift through the inner arch of the foot, drop the tailbone, open the chest, let the chin drop a little bit down. Inhale, arms are coming up, look up. And then exhale, fold forward, placing the hands onto the blocks. Inhale, lift the chest, lengthen out of the crown of the head, out of the sitting bones. And then exhale, coming to a high plank. Now in this high plank, check if you have engaged your upper legs, if you have your core strong. And then on an exhale, bend your elbows halfway next to the body, just above the floor. Inhale, curling over the toes, opening the chest, look up. Exhale, curling back. Bending the knees, lifting the sitting bones up, coming to downward facing dog or puppy dog. So puppy dog is with your knees bent. Be sure that you don't lock your knees. And then from here, step your right foot forward. Bend the left knee onto the mat. Flatten the back foot, placing both hands onto the right knee. And then on an inhale, open the chest, and on an exhale, start bringing your weight forward into your right knee, opening the chest, look up, and feel that you're opening up at the front of the hip. Keep breathing. Take about 3, 4, 5 breaths here, how many you like. And then on exhale, let the hands drop down. Inhale, arms are coming up, look up. Exhale, squeeze your shoulder blades together. Inhale, coming to the front. Exhale, squeeze. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Two more. Inhale. And exhale. And the last one. Inhale. And exhale.
Then interlace the fingers behind your back. And then bring the weight still forward into that front knee. And on an inhale, open the chest. Exhale, let the head drop back. And keep breathing. Find your balance, keep quiet. Gently breathing. And then on an inhale, gently coming up. Placing the hands again on the blocks. Curling the back toe. Stepping back into high plank. From here, bend through your elbows just above the floor. Inhale, curling over the toes, opening the chest, look up. And then exhale, curling back, bending your knees, coming into downward facing dog or into puppy dog, whatever you prefer. Then from here, step the left foot forward, bend the right knee onto the mat, flat on the back foot, placing both hands onto the left knee. And then start bringing your weight forward into the left knee. And also here, keep breathing, and this time keep opening the right hip. Just relax all the muscles. And gently, slowly keep breathing deeply into the tightness. So your inhale, you're bringing it to the tight areas. Exhale, let go. Okay, from here, bring your hands next to your leg. Exhale, inhale, arms are coming up. Exhale, squeeze the shoulder blades together. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, look up and exhale, squeeze again. Massage the back of your heart. Inhaling up, look up, opening the chest. Exhale, squeeze. Keep bringing the weight forward, right hip. And the last one. And squeeze. And when you're down with your arms, interlace the fingers again. Inhale, opening the chest. Exhale, let the head drop back. Keep breathing. And then on the next inhale, come up. Bring your hands back onto the blocks. Curl the back of the toes, and then step into a high plank again. From here, bend your elbows again, exhaling. Inhaling, curling over the toes, opening the chest, look up. Exhale, curling back, bending the knees. Come into downward dog. And from here, bend your knees, look forward. And you can step or jump to the front of your mat. Inhale, lengthen. And then exhale, fold forward again. Inhale, arms are coming up to the side. And exhale, lower the arms again. So from here, start bringing all the weight onto the right foot. See if you can lift the left knee up. And then catch with both hands your left knee. See if your left foot is awake. On an exhale, see you can start bringing your nose towards your knee. Inhale, straighten again up. And then bring your right hand on the outside of your left knee. And bring the left hand up. Make a hook of 90 degrees of your left hand, the left elbow. And then inhale, lengthen out of your leg, out of the crown of the head. And then exhale, rotate to the back from more or less the left elbow. Inhale, lift out of the foot. Lengthen, and then exhale, rotate again a little bit more to the back. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, rotate back. Inhale, lengthen. And exhale, coming back down to center. Slowly releasing the left foot down. Now we're bringing the weight onto the left foot. So bring all the weight onto your left leg. Inhale, lifting up the right knee. Catching. With both hands, your right knee, flexing the right foot. Feel that you're stabilizing through the left foot. And exhale gently, gently, going back down with your nose towards your knee. You don't have to touch it, it's just a direction. On an inhale, coming back up, taking the left hand on the outside of your right knee, bending your right elbow, 90 degrees more or less. If you feel you're unstable, you can bend your left knee a little bit. Inhaling, lifting up the left foot. Exhaling, rotating to the right. Inhaling, lengthen. Exhaling, rotating to the right. Inhaling, lengthening out of the crown of the head. Exhaling, rotating to the right. Last one, inhale. Exhale, rotate to the back. On the next inhale, gently coming back. And then lowering the right leg again back onto your mat. You're standing on both feet again. Come and stand in front of the mat again. And then on an inhale, lift your arms up. And exhale, fold forward again, placing your hands on the blocks. Inhale, lengthening out of the chest, out of the crown of the head, out of the sitting bones. And then on an exhale, step back with your left foot. So your left foot is stepping back. You can place the blocks to the side and then bring both hands on the inside of your right foot. And then gently, gently bring the left ear towards the floor. If you feel that's too much, you can also lower your knee, flatten your back foot, and then come down towards the floor. You can stay there for one or two breaths, or you can stay longer if you want. Then curl the toes under again, then come with your right hand on the outside of the right foot. Come into high plank, and from here, bend your knees a little bit and come into puppy dog. Just look at your navel. Then from here, stepping the left foot forward, and then bring both hands on the inside of the left foot. Gently start bringing your right ear towards the mat. And again, if it's too much, you can lower your foot, flatten your foot on the mat, and just lower down. Stay a few breaths here. Just see how long you feel you want to be there. Any variation is okay. You can stay up here, you can bend through your elbows, you can use blocks as well if you feel you need a little support. It's all fine. Just stay as long as you feel you like, but stay at least like a minute or so. And curling the back toe again, coming back up into a high plank. And then from the high plank, bend your knees, lifting your sitting bones up, and come into a downward facing dog again, or into puppy dog. From here, let's bend our knees and look forward, and let's come and jump to sit. Then take a block and come and lay down on your back. So be sure that you have your blocks near you. And then on an inhale, press the feet into the mat, and then first place the block under your pelvis with the flat end. And relax the whole pelvic bowl onto the block. Just relax the arms next to the body. And start to relax the upper legs and the glutes and your stomach, your intestines. And just take a few nice deep breaths here. Stay as long as you like. If you really feel that you can let go of any tension that you hold, and if you feel you're holding tension into your stomach, just see if you can bring your inhale there, and with the exhale you can release as much as you can. So really bring the focus to the stomach, the lower back area, and the glutes. When you're ready with this pose, just on an inhale, press the feet into the mat, lift the pelvis up, take the block from under, and gently roll your whole back onto the mat again. Take one or two breaths here before we go to the next step. And then again, on an inhale, press the feet into the mat, maybe come even onto your toes, and lift the pelvis up and place the block with the short end and on the high end under your pelvis. So again, under the sacrum actually.
Keep your knees bent and bring your hands next to the body. And now here, really, really see if you can relax your butt, relax your belly, relax your legs as much as possible, and just keep breathing. So if you feel any tension, maybe at the hips, maybe at the lower back, inhale there, exhale, let go. If you feel you have the space for it, you can walk your legs away from the block, just straighten the legs out, lengthen even more. If you want, you can even bring the arms overhead and just open up the front of the body. Taking nice, deep, long breaths. Letting go of as much tension as you can. Start walking your feet back towards the block. You can stay here for about 3 to 5 minutes if you like. I'm just gonna sweeten up a little bit for now. Catch your block again, so bring the hands back overhead. Come onto your toes and inhale, press the toes into the mat, lift the pelvis up, take the block from under and start lowering your back down. And see if you can extend your legs. Place your right hand on your belly, the left hand on your heart, and just take a few breaths here. Notice that your curve in the lower back has increased. And maybe that you have let go of some tension at the hip flexors, maybe at your belly. When you're in this position, it will be a nice moment to transition to the closing part that Savitri has videoed for you. So, I would say go from here into Shavasana, take a final relaxation.
So when you are lying on your back and you've taken a few breaths there, just easily transition into Shavasana. And Savitri has videoed a nice final closing session for you. So you can add that on after this practice. Thank you for watching.